Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome to Let's Play Airport CEO. With me, TapersCrazy, a series of placing Hollow Knights, which was one of those two words I'm not too bothered about tenses for the moment being, but Hollow Knight is a very difficult Metroidvania game, so this is completely different ballpark, and I do this every single Let's Play, it seems, where the last LP was something which was the polar opposite of what the current game is. So there you go, I've gone from Metroidvania to a management game, and I've got to say I've got a bit of variety going on, haven't I? I've got Phoenix Wright, which is sort of a visual novel puzzle game, Need for Speed, which is a racing game, and The Witcher, which is an open world RPG. So Jesus, I've got a lot to think about. Anyway, I've been babbling on about this, nothing to do with Airport CEO for a minute now. But just to give you a brief overview, if anyone's ever played Prison Architect, it's essentially that, but with really angry, impatient passengers rather than prisoners. Let's get stuck in with a new airport. And the first thing I noticed about this game is it's got this customization feature, which is good. I would say, I mean, it does give you these customization options, but ultimately it doesn't really have any bearing on the game, to be honest. So personally, I think it's a nice feature, I just don't see the point of it, but it is what it is. We shall create my character and move into the game itself. My parents loved me, they called me Tapers with the last name Crazy. Okay, I'll just build an airport outside York, I guess, and call it York International Airport. Even though this is a bit annoying with this, because, like, you can call it York International Airport and it would just be a grass airfield, because the idea is you'd start small and build big, as with all management games. So, YIA, which is probably used by an airport already, but we don't care. And we'll play on moderate, just so I've got a few things to think about. Okay. So, the first thing we want to do is, you know, skip you, pause this. Essentially, I'll be following these tutorials. So, starting from a small airfield and building up to a large international airport. So, what I would like to do is move these things so they're sort of not in the way of the main road and blocking traffic as it comes in and out of the airport. So I'll just quickly move those out of the way. We've got the contractor offload site, which we shall just place like so. And we also have our loading site, which we shall also move here. So let's just build the roads up. Is the roads medium quality? No, I only care about medium quality, because the idea is we need to be as stingent. Is the word stingent a proper word for this? But essentially what we need to be is we need to use as little money as possible to do this. So that's what I'm going to focus on doing. Just let this get built up. We should see a few buses and lorries come in. So a lorry to drop off all our materials to build whatever it is we've built. Ah, but we can't build. You notice that there's no one here to build anything. So, that's the first thing we need to think about. What you need to do to get some contractors into this place to build your airport, you need to go to economy and look at your contracts that you can sign. So, you normally start off default with these guys, so Brickley and HWI. Maybe some of us. I'm not sure if that's a standard, but what these are contractors, and what these guys do is provide you with workers that will build the airport. So I'm just gonna look at the details. So we'll get 61 contractors, which means we'll get more stuff built for $8.20 an hour, and here we'll get even more, but they cost more. So I'm just gonna go for the cheap, just to save it, just to make the hourly savings, but that's still not enough. We've signed the contract, but there'll be no workers coming. And to get these workers in, you need to go to operations, then select construction. And here is where you actually deploy these contractors. So What I'm going to do is just deploy them all, because we're in the initial building phase of this airport, so we want to get this built as quickly as possible to make this profitable as quickly as possible. And when the demand drops for stuff we need to build, we'll just dismiss them. So now that that's been done, we should see some school buses come in. Yes, school buses, prison buses, whatever you want to call them. We should see these guys start coming and building this road. Okay, yes, I know about the small airfield. And we're going to build that pretty quick since there's so many of them. And now that that's been done, I'll destroy these two. I've accidentally destroyed the wrong one. It happens on your recording, but, you know. And that should be that. So, what's the first things we need to do to build a small airfield then? So, the most important part of an airport, some would argue, is the runway itself. So, let's build a small grass runway. Way over here. Now, the way I like to do it, and this is probably not cost effective, is build the runway way up here so you've got room for expandability. But I'll build it a bit closer to the middle. Or might be able to demolish it in future if we need to. So I'll just build that there for now. And expand this way over terminal building, I think. So that'll be the small runway built. The next things we need to do is have some runway entrances and exits. So here you can see that runway entrance and exit. We'll just have low quality, just so the aircraft can get on and off the runway. And I like to set it at least one away from the end, just so it doesn't look like one big block. I like having things look pretty as much as possible. What I would like to do also now is join this up with some taxiways. So we go to Taxiway Foundation, normal, low quality, and ideally, I believe you should have them about 5 wide, because 5 wide should be enough to hold pretty much any aircraft, which is what we're after. So we want to build essentially in a way that we can expand in future, but not have to expand every little thing, you know? Like, I don't have to come back and do taxiways 5 wide because a plane doesn't fit or something. Okay. And the next thing we need to do is build a few small general aviation stands. So you can have these aircraft stands. We'll have them low quality. I don't want to build. Now you can't have crosswalk. You can't have roads coming over taxiways, I don't think. So it'd be pointless for me to build that anyway further away from the taxiway. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, and we shall build a taxiway which runs down here, just so the planes can get to and from these stands. And I've mentioned that these are for general aviation, and what general aviation is just planes that land and take off and use airport services without you really having to do a single thing. They just manage themselves, not like your scheduled flights which will land at specific stands. And you have to wire everything up and get the schedule sorted. This is just a way to make a bit of pocket money, which is what we're after to begin with. So we've got that. And that is pretty much all I need for now. I'm considering adding another 2. But I don't want it coming too far down. Aircraft stand. Okay, no, I'll leave that is for now. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to run the simulation. And then I'll cut back to you once this is all built up. And we'll start building our taxiway paths. And there we go. As you can see, we have now. It's pretty dark, so you can't really see anything at all. But as you can see, everything's been built up now. So I'm just going to pause the simulation. And before I do anything else, I think that's the main stuff really built. So I'm just going to dismiss about half of my contractors. So... I shall 35, so we'll dismiss those contractors just so we're not hemorrhaging money every hour on these guys. But there's a few configuration things we need to do here to get this airport up and running. First and foremost, we need to open up the runway. Oh, we need some more things for that, but is what it is. Can I open the rest of this? So for the runway entrance and exit, I'm having the left as an entry. Because I want the aircraft to come this direction. And this is going to be an exit only. So the next thing we need to do to make sure that all this is wired up is do these things called taxiway paths, and these are essentially just the lights which go down the middle of a taxiway, which guide planes to where they need to be. And once we connect all these up, then the planes will be able to get around the airport quite easily. So let's play that just so it loads all that up. And I don't think we can open anything until we've got all the... Oh no, we can. We'll open all of these stands, and then we'll choose our accepted flight types, which is general aviation. Just to make sure that all these stands can accept planes whenever they're ready to land. Just get all those up, and it turns all the lights on as well. Now I don't know if turning stands off actually saves you money. I pressed there. Pressing Z apparently does something, but oh well. Okay, so all those stands are open, but we can't open a runway because, as it mentioned, we need to build a tower. So let's just go back to our aircraft infrastructure and build a small tower just up in this corner. Just to get that bit sorted out. Is there anything else the tutorial suggests that we do? Nope, just a small ATC tower. So that should be built quite handily since we've got so many contractors to pick up that job. And I've left half my contractors here rather than getting rid of them all, because I know eventually we're going to be building some more buildings in a terminal effectively. So, just need a guy to come in. I didn't dismiss them all, did I? No. Wait, is it... What's going on? Is it taking them all away and just giving me 30? I have no idea what's going on. But guys, we've got a... Oh, there we go. There we wave. The building. Excellent. And when this is built, we can open up the runway ready to accept air traffic tomorrow morning. Okay. There we go. So we should now be able to open the runway. Excellent. So let's take a look at that. Yes, we've done it. Hooray. So step three, we need to actually open our airport and make sure that we're allowing general aviation. Oh God, I'm allergic to things that make sense. Right. Okay. So operations is where you can control your airport opening. So we shall open our airport, and there should also be a button here which says allow general aviation. Now, the reason you might want to turn this off is because you might have a gigantic international airport which relies heavily on scheduled flights to make money. And having random aircraft coming in and out just screws it all up. So, it's a good option to turn off if you don't even make money off these guys anymore. But for an early airport like mine, they're kind of necessary. So, now that all that's done, I'm just going to skip ahead to the next day. And this will skip me to 4 o'clock very quickly. And then we're going to hopefully start watching some aircraft land at our airport. And I've really flown through this, haven't I? We've spent day one just really building up the airport, which is ideal. And for the time being, I don't think that this is the most profitable way to use the airport, having general aviation. Before they did all the updates and stuff many, many months ago, I used to be able to just build a terminal and have it that making money, because the real core money from this game comes from your scheduled flights, which we'll get to eventually. This is just about building our infrastructure up and making sure we're not hemorrhaging too much money. So hopefully these aircraft will land sometime soon. Should start landing about 7 o'clock, I would have thought, maybe 6, once it starts becoming daytime. There we go! And you get money for pretty much every operation that an aircraft does. So landing, coming into park, and they've got to pay rental to stay in here and everything. So at the moment it looks like we're just going to make money off air landing. And every hour they've got to pay a certain amount of money to be at this airport. So... we'll just watch until 5 aircraft land, and they'll immediately move on to the next money-making scheme, which is probably going to be fuel. Okay, so there's 3. Where's my 4th? And what's the word like on this? We're already on 96% and we've had 4 flights. So each aircraft will take away 1%, it seems. Which kind of makes sense. I actually like that. It means that you can tell how many aircraft you've got until you need to repair it. So about 100. Right, so what's next on the agenda now that we've landed at 5 flights? Yes. We need to construct some refueling services. So the first thing we need to do is procure the ability to handle fuel. And to do that, you have to go into economy. And there's this purple button called procurement. And this is where you effectively research different functionalities of an airport. So fuel, to name one. So we shall spam filter for $150. Requirement CIO. As if you need a CIO to get rid of a spam filter. Oh my goodness. Chief Information Officer, you. Right, okay, so let's stop dealing about and wait for this avgas to unlock. So, actually, while that's going on, I know I'm going to need service roads, so I'll give my contractor something to do. So we'll go to infrastructure and transport, and you get this different sort of road called a service road, and this is where your airport cars run around and stuff, like your service cars and your fuel trucks. They're on up and down service roads, and generally you don't want any public traffic on there. And we shall also add a vehicle checkpoint, because we're going to need one. Because what a vehicle checkpoint does is allow you, once you buy a fuel truck, it's got to come up the road into the airport. If you've not got a checkpoint, it'll not know how to get into your airport. So it's a very important thing to have. So that, and we'll have a public road here. And we shall watch this get built while the avgas gets procured. And also watch the small aircraft landing at our airfield. See, if I had more general aviation, we'd be landing more flights. But it is what it is. It seems to be kind of a nice little conveyor belt we've got going on. Always going to be planes landing and that. Okay, so now they're building the service road. I just need to keep an eye on making sure this is being procured in another 40 minutes. Oh god, it is a busy airfield, isn't it? So much going on. And yes, even with half of the contractors, you can see that it's getting built. Massive. We're not really seeing any slowdown in our building. Right, okay. So we've now unlocked that. Which means we also need to purchase a fuel truck. So what do we want? I want one that's going to cost less to run every hour, even though this is slower. So I shall have requirements. Oh yes, of course. I need to actually purchase a vehicle depot, which is here. Now this is what the tutorial advises as well, isn't it? Right. Service vehicle parking lot. Now I don't need it. Do I need a service vehicle parking lot? I don't think so. Allow service vehicles to park in a structured visible manner. If it's cheaper, then I'd rather use that. No, it's only an extra 50 an hour. Yeah, I'll just build the vehicle depot, man. Okay, we shall build it. Like so. Just so the truck can come in and out easily. And that'll be built pretty quick, I would have thought. I wouldn't have been able to... actually, I should have really built that while I was waiting. It is what it is. What else do I need? Once I've got the procurement done, I also need to buy some fuel tanks. Which I can also get from the infrastructure. So, a small avgas fuel depot should give me everything I need. For the moment being. But these are 3x3, aren't they? Okay, what I'll do is I'll build it. I shall build the fuel depot right across from the small vehicle depot, because for some reason I think these only work on mediums, to be honest. But it is what it is. A small fuel depot for our purposes at the moment is fine. So we'll just let these get built up. And as soon as that vehicle depot has been built up, I'm gonna quickly go purchase a avgas truck. Okay, is that nearly done? Okay, and actually, now that all this is done, I can Effectively get rid of... How many do I have at the moment? Deployed. Dismiss 10. So that should give me... 16 contracts. I'll get rid of a 6. I just want to have 10. So dismiss the other 6. And now that that's built, we should be able to purchase our truck. So economy, procurement. We shall order that one truck. And it should be coming any moment now. But that's not all. Because once we've got this small fuel depot, it's sort of a similar situation to contractors, really. So you can't just sit here and think, oh, this has got infinite fuel. We need to actually get a contract for the fuel to be delivered to our airfield. So if we go back to offer contracts, you can see we've got a new offer for nature fuel. And what you can see here is Avgas, it's $1.54 per litre. And how much does this fill? 30,000 litres. So we're talking... It's going to be 60,000, I think, if my maths right. I'm not very good at maths. Just to fill up this one depot. And then the truck's going to fill it up. So I think we're going to take a hit of 120k right off the bat. Because what's going to happen is when we accept the contract, we're going to send a fuel truck out to fill up this depot. Then my truck's going to fill its tanks up and retreat into the vehicle depot. And then another truck's going to come just to refill this. So... we're going to take a bit of a financial hit, which is a bit of a bummer, but it is what it is. I don't know why I did that. I think I thought the vehicle was this way for some reason, but it isn't. Right, okay, so let's watch all this happen. We should see our truck come up, and I think this is a... No, that's a contractor's bus. We should see a fuel truck come up, which is this guy, I think, who's going to come and fill my... fuel depot, and then our own Avgas fuel truck. You can see just how much money it's sinking away. Okay, and this should immediately come in and fill its tanks up. And you can see it's emptying it. We might be okay actually, because I think they come and fill it up on 10%. So it's not awaiting incoming resupply. Right, and from there, we should start seeing probably this next plane that's landed. Hopefully, we will see. The fuel truck come out. No, maybe it's got to be one more plane. Basically, they've got a request fuel, unless I've not permitted it. Let's go to operations. Yes, I shall enable my Avgas fuel. I knew I was forgetting something. There we go. And we should now see that fueling's enabled on these stands. Yes, okay. And there we go. The fuel truck's starting to come out and fill all these planes up. Which is good because that gives us more money. So let's just see what's in store for us next episode. Yeah, we just need to refuel 5 aircraft. So I'll let the fuel truck run around and refuel these aircraft. And we'll see what it is we're going to be doing in the next episode. Because we've got a very nice small functioning airfield. Whether it's profitable or not, I don't know. We've got rid of all the contractors and everything's grass. So all I need is a lawnmower to keep this place running. The runway is already nearly 50%, and it's been running for one day. How much is it to repair? $2,000? Just send a bloody lawnmower down the damn thing. Okay. I'm not sure how many I've refueled now. And there you go. We've now got our little small airfield running. So I'll just pause it there. And next episode, what we'll want to be doing is, we've completed the small airfield. We're going to start building up our regional airport. So, next episode, I'm going to start with the terminal building, which is going to be around here, and then have aircraft stands down here. But we'll see how far we get through. Anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.